Hey everyone, welcome to Jotform. My name is Kimberly, and today I am going to create a survey form to send to my team just to really gather intel and feedback on how I can do better for them going into the next quarter. Now, Jotform has a ton of survey templates, so let's jump over to the dashboard and let's start creating our form.
All right, the first thing we need to do is you need to go up to the top left and choose create a form. Now, if you have a form that you have seen other people use that you like, or a friend that already has a survey that you're wanting to clone or make a copy of, you can use this import form option and it'll let you import from a web page. So if you have that link, you can use it here and it'll automatically clone their form for you. We can also start from scratch, which is what I normally do, but Jotform, like I mentioned, has a ton of templates. So let's check out the templates first. And you can see over on the left-hand side, there's lots of different types and even industries if you're industry specific. Down here, we have survey templates. You can see there's almost 500 templates. So let's go ahead and take a look through here. So we have relationship surveys, school surveys, ones for employees, satisfaction. I think that's where I'm going to land. I want to get their feedback and see how satisfied they are with me. We have marketing, product surveys, and then of course we have other survey templates as well. Now, something else that you can do under the templates tab is you can search. So if you're looking for a specific keyword, you can definitely type it in up here. But I'm gonna go back down here to the satisfaction. I'm gonna choose the see all. I wanna see more satisfaction surveys. So we have customer satisfaction. Here's an employee satisfaction. As I'm scrolling, my eyes tend to go to this one right here, the student satisfaction, but we can totally edit it to make it fit what we're looking for. So I'm gonna go ahead and use template. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come over here and I'm gonna start editing each of these pieces to fit more of what I am needing. So for me, this is gonna be a team satisfaction survey. I'm gonna go ahead and delete optional because we do want their name required. I will also choose the properties over here and make that required. For class year, since we are doing team instead of students, I'm gonna go ahead and put level, and then I'm gonna put in the different levels, just like they have students, I'm gonna put the different levels. Perfect. Then over here on the side, we're also gonna make this one required. And then this is where the questionnaire is going to come into place where I want them to give me feedback. Now for these number scales, we have very dissatisfied and very satisfied from 1 to 10. So keeping that in mind, let's start editing some of these questions. Let's start with, I received adequate support this quarter. So you can see it coming down to this second question, it goes from very dissatisfied to not so well and very well. So instead of changing what these are, which I definitely can, I'm gonna go ahead and leave the not so well and very well, and I'm gonna tailor it to them. So how do I feel my performance was? All right, for the next question, I want to know, we have a live training that we do every week. I wanna know, is that the best mode and is it at the best time? So let's do good deal. All right, so the rest of these, I honestly don't need that many questions. Rather, I don't need that many number scales. So I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of these extra ones. And then I want them to be able to give me specific feedback. So I'm gonna be using the short text. So over here under add form element on the left, we'll go down here and we'll choose short text and we'll drag it in. And we could also definitely use long text here as well. So I'm all about start, stop, continue. So with this one, I am going to make this one, what are some things we should start doing? We'll drag in another one. What are some things we should stop doing? We'll drag in another short. What are some things we should continue doing? All right, I think that is pretty much it. So I'm gonna go in here and make all of these questions required. And technically, thinking back, we could We could make these optional, right? I don't want them to feel forced to answer those questions. So I'm going to go ahead and turn those back off. And then for the submit button, we can come up here under settings and then the thank you page. And I want to edit this. We're here. It says your submission has been received. I'm going to put thank you for your feedback. Here's to a great next quarter. Perfect. All right, I'm gonna go back to build. I actually like the colors and how everything looks, but we can come back up here to the form designer if we want to change any of the colors. Let's try this yellow and orange. I don't know, I think I like the other one better. So with this, I just am gonna use Command Z or Control Z just to go back. And I'm good with those. So from here, we can go to publish, grab the link, and we are good to go. And that is pretty much it. Whenever we changed our header up here, it went ahead and changed the name of our form. And that is pretty much it for this form. If you guys have any questions about making your own survey form, just drop it down below in the comments, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye, y'all.